हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आप सभी का फिर से एक बार स्वागत है मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल में जिसका नाम है कॉमर्स ट्रेजर। तो फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट टाइम वी स्टार्टेड अ सीरीज़ वेर इन आई वॉज टेलिंग यू अबाउट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स विच यू नीड टू कवर अंडर ईच चैप्टर ऑफ NTA नेट कॉमर्स पेपर 2। सो वी स्टार्टेड विथ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस एंड बिजनेस एनवायरमेंट विच लिंक ऑफ विच आई गिवन यू इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एज वेल एज इन द आई बटन विच इज़ ऑन द अबोव ऑफ योर वीडियो। सो प्लीज वॉच इट इफ यू हैवेंट वॉच इट येट। So let's go today to the next topic, which is banking and financial institutions. Now friends, this chapter again is a very very easy chapter. Just what you have to do is you have to focus on dates and you have to focus on objective of some important institutions. On this you are going to get questions in match the following upon dates, or else you are going to get questions on statement form, whichever is right or wrong you have to find it out. And it is one of the easiest chapter, as I said, in your NTA NET syllabus paper 2. So what all you have to cover, let's see the topic one by one. So first you have to cover about overview of Indian financial system, and in this you have to cover about history of banking, how the banks start, what is the history of Indian banking, where it started, when it started, how it started, everything you have to understand. And you have to study about some important institutions like IFCI, which was started in the year 1948, which was the first institution to set up in India to provide loan, right, which is Industrial Financial Corporation of India. Then ICICI, which is Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, which was set up in 1955. IDBI, Industrial Development Bank of India, which was established in the year 1964. UTI, Unit Trust of India, 1963. LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, 1956, when it got nationalized. NABARD, which is National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, which established in 1982. SEBI, which is established in the year 1988, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. SFC, which stands for State Financial Corporation. So about all this you have to study about their objectives, about their main functions and their head offices or headquarters, as well as date of establishment and under which ownership they are presently working. The next very very simple point is about types of banks. So there are different types of banks. There are commercial banks, what are their functions, RRBs. There are foreign banks, cooperative banks, so functions and the rules which are applicable to these banks. You have to understand this very simple topic, not very, very important, but yes, you can remember because it is one of the easiest topic. The next is about Reserve Bank of India. This is very important topic, friends. One or two questions definitely are going to get on this topic. So history of RBI, how it started, that is in the year 1935, when it was established as a private sector bank, wherein ownership was contributed by government as well as private shareholders, then how it got converted into central bank of our country, and about few historical backgrounds of Reserve Bank of India, its function of monopoly of note issue, bankers bank, banker to the government, custodian of foreign exchange reserves, and so many functions which RBI does, and role and monetary policy, in which you have to study about different measures which RBI takes to control monetary policy in our country, like SLR, CRR, bank rate, repo rate, reverse repo rate, and the different measures. The next important topic which you have to study is about banking sector reforms in India, where you have to study about Basel norms, that is Basel 1, 2, 3, when it started, where it started, in which part of the world, and in India, what impact it has made. Next, you have to study about NPA, that is non-performing asset management of the banks, which are divided into substandard, doubtful, and loss, depending upon how much interest they are getting or from how many months they are not getting the interest on those particular loans which they have given, and about CAR, that is capital adequacy ratio of the banks. The next you have to study about mutual funds and pension funds in India. Now every year one or two questions are asked on mutual funds, about what is mutual fund, how we have to collect funds in mutual funds, about asset management company, which institution started this mutual fund concept in our country, etc. The next point which you have to study is about financial market. Now in financial market you have to study mainly about two markets, that is money market, which is short term market, and capital market, which is long term market, where shares and debentures and all other different long term securities are bought and sold. So in capital market, about shares, about debentures, about methods of issuing shares like right issue or public issue, initial public offering, preferential allotment, private placement, etc. In money market, you have to study about some money market instruments like treasury bills, certificate of deposit, commercial papers, and so on. All these things are very important and they are definitely asked in your exams. Then you have to study about financial regulators in India. Now there are some financial regulators who regulate one particular sector of our country. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आरबीआई रेगुलेट्स द बैंकिंग सेक्टर, सेबी रेगुलेट्स द कंपनीज सेक्टर, पीएफडीआरए रेगुलेट्स द पेंशन फंड सेक्टर, एफएमसी विच इज़ फॉरवर्ड मार्केट कमीशन लुक आफ्टर द कमोडिटी मार्केट, आईआरडीए लुक्स आफ्टर द इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर एंड सो ऑन. सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फाइनेंशियल रेगुलेटर्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. दिस कैन बी आस्क इन योर मैच द फॉलोइंग टाइप क्वेश्चंस. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज़ वेरी न्यू एंड विच हैज़ बीन एडेड रिसेंटली इन योर सिलेबस इज अबाउट डिजिटलाइजेशन ऑफ बैंकिंग एंड अदर फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज. Now you have to study here about mobile banking, internet banking, UPI based banking which we are using like Google Pay or Paytm or your Phone Pay, PayPal etc. And you have to also study about e-wallets and other important new features which the bank is given nowadays. Even now WhatsApp banking has been started, so you can also study about those particular sort of topics. And the last topic which you have to study in this chapter is about types of insurance. There are different types of insurance. You have to study about marine insurance, theft insurance, fire insurance, life insurance and other vehicle insurance etc. Not only that, you have to also study about risk classification and management which are done under insurance and the factors which are limiting the insurability of risk. Sometimes you are also getting question on reinsurance and double insurance. What is double insurance? What is reinsurance? Like double insurance refers to making insurance with two or more different insuring companies, and reinsurance is nothing but when your insurance company gets insured with one more company, it is called as reinsurance. About this you can study. And about regulatory framework of insurance, that is IRDA, how it manages and what it is its role in our country. So this is all about the important topics which you have to study in your banking and financial institutions part. This is traditional concept, as I say, all these things are usually fixed. So once you prepare notes on this, every time you can use the same notes because usually it does not get updated very frequently. So if you like the video, friends, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you can get notification as soon as I upload a new video. So thank you, friends. Meet you again with another good video.